And so I wanted to combine kind of like appropriate technology, off-grid living, together with an EV conversion.
All right, everyone, I'm here with Dave, and Dave's gonna talk to us a little bit about this super awesome Nissan Frontier EV conversion. Thanks, Dave.
You bet, Dan. Yeah, my name's Dave Pence, and I'm a retired shop teacher. I got involved with EVs when my son was in seventh grade. He's now an engineer, graduated from college, and he wanted to do a seventh grade culminating project, and I said, why don't we build an EV scooter? And he liked the idea. I had a couple buddies that were into this, so this was back, 2007. And so we built the EV scooter. He gave a presentation to his classmates, and he invited them to come out to the baseball diamond and ride it after his presentation. And he had about 30 kids come out. So as a teacher, I thought, wow, this is pretty cool for a STEM project.
Yeah.
So it just got me thinking, and so I started to look around. This was now fast forward 2009. I was kind of wrapping up my teaching career, and I had a buddy that did an early EV conversion with lead acid batteries. So I rode in that vehicle and got hooked immediately.
That was it.
Yeah, that was it. And so I bought this on Craigslist for $150. And I took it. I taught at a vocational school in Boulder, and so I brought it over to the automotive department, and the kids put a tilt bed on the back, and so I started, you know, with the idea of putting batteries underneath it, and it just kind of went from there. Actually, it didn't go from there. It sat in my front yard for 14 years. And
that's
there was
the planning stage.
Planning. And there was a number of false starts. I thought that I could just backyard mechanic it. And no, you got to have a lift and, you know, just all the other background information. I bought books and watched videos. But it was just such an overwhelming project for me that I thought I need to get some help. So I joined the Denver Electric Vehicle Council. Since I was a retired teacher at that time, they asked me, would you be our education outreach coordinator for kids?
Awesome.
And I said, sure. You know, I didn't know what I was getting into. So so we started converting mini bikes to electric, and taught some workshops with that with kids. And I finally met Jimmy Underhill with EV Swap. And then he agreed to, you know, take the lead. And this was actually his first conversion for his business. So it's been wonderful. I've driven it now for over a year and just absolutely love it. And I live up in the mountains in the foothills. So the performance, even in the winter, was great. And this is a two-wheel drive.
Okay.
Rear-wheel drive. And this is a Leaf, a 2019 Leaf that we were able to get all the components from. So it fits in here perfect. And since it's a Nissan, you know, the brands match up.
Yeah, it almost looks stock.
Yes.
It almost looks stock.
And what was great about buying that, that wrecked Leaf, we found out that it was a brand new battery.
So oh, cool.
It was at 100%.
Lucky.
So it was only a few weeks old when it was involved in a collision.
So if we come around the side here, I mean, I just got to say, this paint is beautiful. Like, the truck is in really nice condition. This tip-up bed was really key in the way that you guys put the batteries in here. So is this an entire Leaf pack that is shoehorned in under the car?
Yes.
That's amazing.
This is a 40 kilowatt hour pack, so I get about a little over 100 mile range with it. And these are all custom, fabricated battery boxes.
And being a Leaf motor, this has regen built into it when you're driving.
It does.
So when you're coming down the mountain, you get a little bit of juice back?
Yes. I used, coming down from the mountains today, I used 10%.
Wow.
So it was great. And there's a learning curve on how to drive it, you know, to adjust with the regen. But after about a year, I'm getting the hang of it. So it is a little different perspective, in terms of driving.
One other detail that I think is unique is this here. So tell me the story on the solar panel on the back of it.
Well, in addition for this, designed as a teaching tool. So what I wanted, in fact, the nickname for this vehicle is Elvis.
Elvis.
And it stands for Electric Learning Vehicle Involving Students. And so I wanted to combine kind of like appropriate technology, off-grid living, together with an EV conversion. So the whole idea of recycling, the whole idea of repurposing this vehicle, putting it back on the road, and combining that with solar technology. So we'll eventually have, this is almost a 400 watt panel, and then I'll have another panel on the roof of the cab, and then another panel on the hood. So we'll have, maybe around 600 watts. And these will act as trickle chargers. And then I have an off-grid cabin down in the San Luis Valley in Colorado, southern Colorado. And so the idea is that eventually, once we get long-range CHAdeMO system in this, is I can drive it from the front range, I can go to my off-grid cabin, we can hook it up to the solar array down there, plus use this array, and then basically have free power.
That's amazing. Is it currently trickle charging into the batteries? Or
No. We just installed this. So we're at the beginning phases of trying to design the system where it can actually power the main battery system.
Okay, got it. That's super cool though. And talk about ultimate flexibility to just be able to like constantly have power. What about inside the cab? Has that maintained very similar to the stock feel, or did you have to modify it?
Really, it's pretty much stock.
Wow.
I mean, I was lucky to be able to find a donor vehicle that was in pretty good shape. It doesn't have air conditioning. The heating system is not really sufficient with a little 12-volt, 100-watt or 1,000-watt heating system, but I don't have a defroster, so those are things that, we're still in progress. It's a work in progress.
That's the best cars are. Well, thank you so much, Dave. I really appreciate you taking this through, and I look forward to seeing the next iteration of this build.
Yeah, thanks, Dan. Thanks for asking.
I guess one more question, if you don't mind me asking. What was the ultimate price for this build when you factor in the Leaf that you had to salvage, and you got the best deal on this?
Yeah. It was a killer deal off of Craigslist. I'll probably eventually have maybe $15,000 in it.
That's achievable. That's an achievable bill.
It is. And that's what I want to try to get across to students when I want to take this out to school, middle schools and high schools and vocational technical schools, and just show kids that this is just a big STEM project.
Yeah.
That could be done, as a class or as a program unto itself. So I think it's something that, there's a lot of used parts from this that we got, repurposed parts. So it's not, even though, we look at some of these other vehicles here, the classic vehicles, they're six figures.
Yeah.
But this, I think, if you if you plan it out, if you are able to, you know, just source parts from junkyards, you know, things are out there. And I'd recommend something, you know, kind of, this is a 98, so this is before all the you know, can additions and everything right. else. So I think that makes it simpler. This was actually the first year, 98, I believe, was the first year that they had the Nissan Frontier. So find a vehicle that's very, very simple to work on.
That's good advice. Thank you, Dave.
All right.